Well, I tried.
Ladies and gentlemen, I tried. I went over there to see if Mr. Cruzy Bear wanted to come over and be a part of this video, but he literally looked at me like, nope, I got a girl over here rubbing my belly in front of the shop. Dad, you go do your own thing. I'm good. Hey, everybody. We're still on the property at Reoutfitted, and we are going to be here for quite some time. We have a lot of things on the go, and honestly, these last few days, I've really just been hanging out and enjoying some time right here in our own little place, connected to a little bit of Wi-Fi from the shop, and there's even bathrooms and showers on the other side of the building that I have access to anytime I want. So it has been pure van life heaven. This is just gonna be a quick update. I got some things that I wanna cover. Some people asked me about the fuel cost, how much it cost me to get here. So I did really, really, really good with tracking my fuel until the last fill up, because I just got too darn excited and I forgot to track the kilometers and the fill up. So we're gonna give you the stats on where I stopped tracking it. So we're probably about 4,500 or 4,600 kilometers into this trip, and I stopped tracking it at 4,179 kilometers, which is pretty much just about here. So 4,179 kilometers cost me $760 in fuel, which is actually a little bit better than I was expecting it to be. It turns out that my van gets around 18 cents per kilometer on the average. Sometimes it's higher, sometimes it's lower, but by calculating all those numbers together, 18 cents a kilometer. And I think the last time we did this trip, I think I was averaging 16 or 17 cents per kilometer. So adding the bigger tires and all this extra stuff is maybe added an extra penny per kilometer, which at the end of the day, those things are just so much more convenient to have. The bigger, chunkier tires are gonna help us out a lot in backcountry scenarios. So to pay that little extra for a little bit more luxury is no big deal at all, no complaints. So there's been an influx of people messaging me, messaging Reoutfitted. Yes, they've been messaging them because they can't get a hold of me on any social media, wanting to meet up with me and Cruz. So we're not going to be doing any meetups, any face-to-face stuff, no gatherings whatsoever at all while we are out here, mainly because of COVID. So we're all stuck in some really crappy situations because of all this, and I just don't want to do any organized gatherings in this time and then me getting in trouble for certain little things because certain protocols weren't followed during my pretty much it's a gathering. No gatherings at all, guys. So sorry about that. And there's been so many emails from people that I haven't been replying to them. So if you guys have messaged them, don't do that. If you've messaged them or you've messaged me, now you guys know we're not going to be doing any face-to-face gatherings. We're trying to keep our circle pretty small out here because these guys are a business, and Andy's shop is a business. So we have to kind of maintain their protocols that they have set out for themselves, which means their customers need to keep their circles very small. I know you guys can understand that one. So while we're here, a lot of thought processes have been going on while I've been sitting here chatting with Madison and Rainer and stuff like that about my van and about my business and building like the ultimate van for a YouTuber, someone who's earning a living online and allows me to get out here and film some things. So there's been some additions we've been thinking about adding to my van that I've thought about before, but never really, the thought process never became a reality because doing some things myself like that, I don't have access to doing those things myself or gathering the people to do it. So while I'm gonna be here for over a month, I'll be here till, what's the date today? So probably another 6 or 7 weeks I'll be around here. So we're gonna be planning out some projects that I never thought I would ever. We got some cool stuff coming up. Let's just put it that way. So some of the things that came up in discussion were adding a cell phone booster to my van. Because Reoutfitted has a camper van of their own and they have a Wii Boost cell phone booster and they love it. They say it works so good. It's allowed them to do work when they're in some not so desirable cell phone areas in the backcountry. And that's perfect for me because it allows me to go do more backcountry adventures and still yet stay connected to be able to upload videos. So I ordered myself one of those WeBoost RV cell phone boosters. They were not cheap. They ran like $500. But, I mean, we're losing our light here. Let's move backwards just a little bit. But that's going to allow me to do a little bit more work in those backcountry areas without having to have a great off-road adventure and then drive all the way back into town just to get enough cell phone reception to upload videos. But those are the kind of things that we've been brainstorming and planning while I'm here and I have access to an amazing shop and a professional that can do the work for me. So we've been really just kind of thinking about, let's get everything done to the van now while we have access to the people that can do it for us. So I have a funny feeling this trip's going to be a little bit more money than I had planned, but I think when we leave here, our van is going to be polished off to exactly what we need to continue our van life journey and continue to produce YouTube videos and make our lives just a little bit easier. And one of those things that we're going to be adding to the van is also an onboard air compressor. So now that we have those big chunky KO2s and we're putting a spare tire on the back door, I'm going to be adding an air compressor, not a portable one, like an actual onboard air compressor to the van, which should fill up my tires in about a minute and a half a piece. Means when I get out in the backcountry, I can air down a little bit, have a little bit of a smoother ride, and or if I get into a really mucky situation, I can air right down, grab some more traction, get out of the muck, refill up my tires, back on the road, and we're traveling again. These are the cool little things that happen when you're out at a professional van builder, because you get a chance to really work out everything that you need to build, like the ultimate camper van for a filmmaker. Super stoked. I've also been really planning on stickering out my van. That's been on my mind for a very long time. So my little advertisement right there that I absolutely love to have on my van. Funny story. There's been a few times where I've been walking down a trail, someone's walking and they're watching my video. They look up and they're like, is that your camper van back there? I'm like, yeah. They're like, is that your YouTube channel? They're like, yep. They're like, I just seen it and I just logged on, so I'm gonna walk and watch your videos. Pretty damn cool. So it's nice to know that things like that actually work on the van, but that's where the spare tire is going. And I don't know if I want the look of that logo on my windows or anything weird. I'm not really sure. So while we're going to be sitting semi-static here, I might bounce out to some of the local towns around here, because this town here is really small, and see if there's any sign shops that can help me put together a little bit of a plan for some small advertising. Nothing's going to be big, but maybe a logo on the side about that big and some trees and something that just, like, you know what I mean? So I'm going to be putting some plans into that. So maybe when I leave here, my van will be just like deckled up with some Van City Van Life, follow us on YouTube kind of stuff. So, and there's been a few times on my travels where I've pulled into a sign shop. Fingers crossed they happen to have a slow day or something like that. I'm like, hey, do you guys got time to do a project? They're like, no, next week maybe. I'm like, okay, I'm out. Hit another little town. I'm like, hey, do you guys happen to have time? They're all like, no, maybe next week. So maybe while we're here, might be the time to take the leap and get some cool stuff done. It's not going to be like no great big huge advertisement, and it will definitely suit the van. It'll probably be like black trees with my logo, something super tough and fun. I think it would just polish up the whole look of this adventure van that we've been seriously like polishing off in the last 6 months here. Speaking of how fast things have been coming, like, no, you, some people have messaged me saying, hey, Chrome, you seem to be doing a lot of changes pretty quick. You know, what's going on? You know, like, did you get rich or something? And the answer to that is no, I am not rich. So things have been going very well with the channel, and we have been grinding our butt off on this channel for 3 years. Coming up in a couple of weeks, we'll have been 3 years on YouTube. So all this work has slowly finally been paying off. Like, our views are going up. We've been getting a lot more brand deals. I know you guys have seen stuff on my channel, like from Skillshare and Surfshark and of course Jackery and stuff. So There's been a few more brand deals on my channel, which has allowed me to bring in chunks of money because those brand deals actually pay a lot. So whenever you hear a sponsor on my channel, those guys are paying $400 or $500 for 45 to 60 seconds of our time, my time and your time to listen to me babble about it. So they do very much help a lot of the stuff that we're doing to my van now. And that's why I've been taking on so many brands, is because it really honestly just helps us progress forward. That's how we get to build our ultimate home, is to take on more business offers like those. But on that note, I have said no to so many brand deals. I actually said yes to two of them, which were supposed to go in videos this month. And I ended up emailing them saying, hey guys, I just don't think it's a right fit for us right now. Call me back in January. But yeah, I just haven't felt the need. Like, I would have bombarded this month because I knew there was a lot of money going out this month. So I was gonna do a little bit more brand deals. And something inside of here said, you know what? You do three on a month. That should be enough for now. So we've actually said no to two of them. I felt bad for saying no, but it feels good not to have to find a way to wiggle it into a video without taking away from the movies that we're making. So anyway, guys, that's how most of us YouTubers get ahead a lot, is all these brand deal offers. And then as the growth of the channel, and if you ever see views go up higher, the higher the views means more YouTube ads, means more revenue for us. And of course, keeping our gas tanks full are our amazing people on Patreon and YouTube memberships. Come on, guys. You're my family. I love you guys. You're my seriously my rock. Anyway, on to the next thing. So while we're going to be sitting here, I have some more talking videos of things that I would like to get out, some topics. And while I've got some time and the space and the privacy and, you know, everything I need right here, I think I might get some of those topics off my chest and onto video finally. Because when you're traveling and things go so fast all the time, you don't get a chance to make those topic videos you've always wanted. Because when you're moving your van every day, you always want to capture what you're doing, because there's so many cool things you're driving past and seeing, and you don't want to miss a filming opportunity. So while we're here, you may see a few more tips and tricks style videos, or me diving into some things in my van, because I spent the day yesterday and I literally rummaged through my entire van thinking we should make some content about what's inside that beast behind me that I call home. So if you guys have any subjects that you would love to hear me make videos about, put them in the comments of this video and I will be active in the comments on this one, and dig through and see what I can do about busting out some videos while we're out here for the next 5, 6, 7 weeks. It's gonna be so good. Anyway, tomorrow's video is my birthday video. So thank you to all of you that wished me happy birthday. And my birthday video is coming out tomorrow. So please press play on that one. It is a super, super fun video. But so yeah, in the next 4, 6, 7 weeks, you're gonna be seeing a lot of changes going on in my van, and I'm super excited about them. Everything I'm adding to my van right now has been well thought out, or things that I've been dreaming about for the longest time. And now that all these years of hard work on YouTube are starting to pay off and all my debt's been cleared and my van is paid off, it's nice to finally take some of this hard-earned income from here and fold it back into making the home, which is our business, and our off-grid adventure mobile a little bit more functional. Man, we're just buying toys. Let's be honest, Chrome. You're just buying the toys you've always wanted. Yes, I am. But everything I'm adding to my van, like anything I've ever done to my van, has always been well thought out. So if you guys are new to my channel, please do me a favor. We have a playlist called Binge Watch It All. I know it seems like a ginormous thing to take on, but even if you were to go watch the first year of my van life, you guys will learn so much about getting into van life. It'll answer all your beginner questions, and you guys will get to experience my journey with me from where it all began, because I've changed a lot in the last 3 years. My van has changed a lot in the last 3 years. So if you guys are brand new into van life and you guys really want to just learn some things, that's the playlist to go check out. It is like, seriously, I've gone back and watched my old videos many, many times. There's times when I don't have cell reception or Wi-Fi to watch Netflix and I don't have any videos downloaded on Netflix. I'll plug in my hard drive from year one or season one of Van City Van Life and I'll start watching them and I'm like, wow, man, there's some amazing videos in here. So treat yourself. Go back there and watch some of those ones. They're actually really good. All right, so sorry that Cruz isn't in this video, but he's up there getting too much love from everybody that's here at the shop. And this shop here at Reoutfitted is busy. There's like things on the hoist and then windows being cut into another van. So expect some of that coming up in videos too. I might just pop in the shop there and see what they're doing and maybe we can do some like how-to videos on some of the stuff that they're doing to other people's vans. All right, guys, we're gonna go. See you later. I'm gonna go get Cruz, one sec. There we go. That was a lot more work. Hey, buddy. Say hi to YouTube. Okay, guys, we're done. Thanks for watching. See you later. Give me a kiss. All right, buddy. You can go back. Hey, you can go back. Whew. That was hard carrying him over here. Okay, bye.